For more on world hunger and global efforts to fight malnutrition, I sat down with Ephraim Nkonya, senior researcher at the International Food Policy Research Institute. I began by asking about progress in farming technology aimed at dealing with the issue.
We are seeing progress in adoption of improved varieties, crop varieties, and also land management, but we still have a big problem in sub-Saharan Africa because 26% of the population is still hungry. And so the problem is still big. It's grown bigger because of many other challenges, including the climate change and other things. But at the same time, we're seeing progress, but the problems are increasing. Population is increasing. Climate change and other challenges are also contributing to the increase of the people who are hungry.
And give us an idea of the scope, especially when it comes to climate change. How much is that weighing on the issue of food security?
It's becoming a very big problem because now the climate change is actually affecting much of Africa. Given that, it is actually affecting more areas which are dry. And the majority of the biggest area of sub-Saharan Africa is dry, and it is the rainfall is becoming more variable and less predictable. And as such, we are seeing a lot of problems of crop failure and other problems.
Now, farmers are then having to be more resilient and trying to be more innovative in really trying to maintain their crops. What are some of the strategies they're using to really try and minimize some of these risks?
I think among the very simple thing that needs to be done is the policies. There are policies, for example, I'm going to give you an example of Tanzania. When there is a drought, the country imposes a cross-border ban, so the food is not exported to our neighboring countries. But our study at IFPRI has shown that if that happens, that the food export ban happens, it actually makes the poor people, the farmers, less food, and their income that goes down by 25%. At the same time, the rich people, the consumers in urban areas, their income goes by 25%. So the policies should be good. It should create incentives for the farmers to be farming and also be avoid all those problems. And the second thing is about women empowerment and education. Those aspects are really important, and I wish I could have more time to tell you about this, but I think let me just stop there. Because those are the major aspects that we have seen to be very important in building resilience against the climate change.
And are we seeing more women coming into this industry as a way to really kind of boost more interest in agriculture?
Women are the ones who are doing the farming. The men are just eating food. So, yeah, women have been there all the time. But the problem is the people who make decisions are always the men. And those are the wrong people to make decisions. Because if you empower women, they are going to be putting good food on the table than when men are making decisions.
Now, I do want to get to an issue that's been plaguing a lot of African countries at the moment, and this is the fall armyworm. We've really seen it devastating a number of crops. We know that Ghana declared a state of emergency for its farmers there. Mm. And some analysts predict that perhaps in as many as 3 years, it could reach Asia. How big of a concern is the fall armyworm at the moment?
Well, I think it has been a very big problem in the past. Actually, we've made progress in controlling armyworms and other other problems that have been like locusts and all that things. Those things are coming, I mean, they are reducing. But yes, they are now with climate change, a lot of things are happening, including such a problem as armyworms and locusts. They're increasing again. But again, we go back to changes in the climate change. Yeah.
And what have been some of the challenges that you've seen in really trying to reduce food insecurity?
The first problem is actually governance. If you look at the problem of hunger now, there are two countries in Africa, only two. South Sudan and Somalia, both of them have one thing in common. There is civil war. Now, governance is a very big problem. And if you see limited governance or low governance or poor governance, we have a problem of food security. Look at DRC Congo. DRC Congo has 30% of the forest stock in Africa is in DRC Congo. 25% of water, fresh water, is in DRC Congo. But that country is the third hungriest country in the region. Why? Why is that the case? Because of governance. Look at Botswana. Botswana is a country which is like a desert, but that country is now in the middle-income country. There is nobody who's going hungry in that country. Simply because of what? Governance is a very big problem. is a very big challenge that we are still seeing, and is contributing very much to the problem of food security in the region.